Well, we certainly enjoyed the 33 pieces of artwork that were brought to us by our competitors this month. And we certainly had quite a variety of interpretations for you. Dan Wright, the manager and vice president of Bank of Nevada, is here with us this evening. Dan is here representing Bank of Nevada, and they are our sponsor for the month. Thank you, Dan. Dan's going to help announce the winners this evening. We have some prize money to give away that was provided by the Bank of Nevada. And we also have some nice ribbons that haven't been announced. I think you'll all be very excited to hear who the winners are of all of our prizes. First of all, I'd just like to go through the list and have everybody who competed this month raise your hand, stand up, show us which one is your artwork, so we can recognize all of you, because we have such a wonderful field of competitors. So let me get our list out here and we'll get started. We have several people who have multiple entries this month, and artist number one is one of them. Jean Wench, where are you?
I'm right here.
Hey, Jean. She has Tiger Lilies, number one, and?
Tito, that is the young woman, and that's what it means, a girl. Tito.
Okay, the portrait there.
And also the little town girl, sad about not being able to golf.
Okay, the tomboy at T number
whatever.
Okay, thanks Jean, thanks for being a good competitor. I don't believe Jim Lanier is here this evening, but Jim has brought us that beautiful watercolor of the lacquer teapot and cups and rose, a tea for two. Ralph LeMaster is not here this evening, but we'll get to him a little bit later anyway. Sherry Chandler. Sherry is one of our brand new members, and Sherry brought us a lovely watercolor called Tea and Tulips. It sold right off the wall about the first day that it was eligible. We did do the judging before it was sold, but we don't have it here to look at today. But there are, I believe, three of Sherry's pieces of artwork here that you can enjoy. Two of them are on both sides of the display above the jewelry cabinet, so you can see what fine work she does. Jan Stensland is number four. Jan? Or, I'm sorry, five. Jan? Very good. Joan Everett there. Great. Judy Huser isn't here this evening. Judy has brought us the pre-1880s grill. I think you'll all see the little tea in the distance there on the green, what do you call that?
Green.
Okay.
Tea box.
Tea box, that's it. I'm quite a golfer. Sorry that Judy isn't here this evening. Susan Holliday, brought us number seven, Mr. and Mrs. T breakfast. Peggy Peterson isn't here today. Peggy always has to take off for the summer, but she was good enough to bring us tea time, number eight on the wall. It's the peach tree with a teapot hanging over the branch. That's quite an interpretation. Sandra Anderson, Red Canyon Trail is number nine. That one we'll also hear later on the list. Sally Sinclair, are you here? Okay, that's too bad. Sally brought us number 10, tee off, the little guy there with the gigantic golf ball. Barb Worley, are you here?
Right here.
Okay, Barb, tell us about your work.
Oh,
which one? Sorry. Barb Worley. With the trees in the back. Okay. The first tee with the trees. Okay. Janice Cosey, are you here?
Yes.
And tell us about yours.
Well, mine is called Time for Tea, and it's the teapot with the sugar bowl and cup, and it's a working clock.
Working clock. Anybody who needs a nice clock for their wall, there it is. Diane Kumrat was here a little earlier, but she couldn't stay. She has three entries with us today. She has that small colored pencil work called Early Tea Time. You can see the just the daylight in the horizon. A nice, very small colored pencil work. And she has two other colored pencil over here. The gentleman sitting with his cup of tea with the hat. And the two folks there having their tea time, that my interpretation of that is tailgate time. Barbara Rowley, are you here? Okay, Barbara, what have you brought us?
Tulip
time, okay. Number 14. Barbara is one of our constant competitors. She's been our artist of the month, and another nice entry with beautiful color. Sherry Benson, what have you brought us today?
I did the two sculptures that are over on the table, entitled Standing Tall in Troubled Times.
Tell us about the materials.
They're both made with paper clay, which is kind of a little different material to deal with. But really fun, like the woman's dress has lace that was dipped in slip and then put on and fired. So there's actually lace in there too.
Oh, so you have other materials in there as well as the clay.
Well, the lace is gone. It's fired out, but it's
okay.
There.
Okay. Very nice entries. Something very unusual too. Okay, we've got Jan Hansen. What do you have for us today, Jan?
Well, I wanted to support the contest, so I'm going to bring my painting in. Judith suggested I name it the Double T Ranch, and that fit.
Okay, it seems to have gotten you a ribbon, didn't it? Some of us have help with our titles, and it seems to work out pretty well. Tammy Simons, where's yours, Tammy?
Okay,
almost a miniature, isn't it?
Yes.
Tammy's Tea Time. We'll hear more about Tammy later. She's one of our prize winners. Sandra Anderson, I'm sorry she couldn't be here today, but she did Red Canyon Towers, the very large watercolor there. Sally Sinclair, again, I'm sorry Sally isn't here, but she has a Time for Tea also. A very nice colored pencil there, the beautiful teacup and the clock. Carol Peterson, I know you're here. Carol, tell us about your work.
Grandma's Hat for Tea is over there.
Okay, is that little girl anybody you know?
No.
No, not a granddaughter. You did bring us a granddaughter one time, I believe.
No, but I will.
Okay. Next girl,
you can have them both.
Okay. The next time you do a little girl, it'll be a granddaughter, okay? It's lovely. Joanne Johansson, not here. Joanne is portraying Thunderstorm. Just beautiful work. And I hope all of you who are looking for a nice little painting for your house, I hope you're all looking around at the moderate prices that all these people have placed on their artwork. If you can't take away a painting tonight, my goodness, I don't know. Lucille Carstensen isn't here, but Lucille brought us a wonderful watercolor called The Invader. And I got to think that golf ball is the invader, not the Roadrunner. Judith Edom, what do you have here tonight, Judith?
I have illuminated manuscript for this. It's a sacred place. It's got tea in it. I stained the paper with tea and gold and wash and ink.
You just have too much fun with your work, Judith. Sandy Cooper. Tell us about yours, Sandy.
All right, mine is the dog and the girl and the doll and the thing. It's in the photo. That's my photo. Who I just asked what to see. So he was so distinguished. I did that over there. I just wanted to thank this whole thing.
Wonderful. I'm so glad you got it done because I know you really had to hustle to get that painting done, and we're glad to have it here. Geraldine Zarati, are you here in the room?
She comes.
Oh, don't run too fast. But Geraldine, do you have a painting here tonight?
Yes, I have a painting here tonight.
Okay.
Mine is the little one right there, a teapot and two teacups. I entitled it Tea Time for Two.
Okay. You can't miss Geraldine's work. Robert Cooper isn't with us tonight, but Robert Cooper is one of the students that Diana and Marianne have been teaching for several years at Highland Manor. And obviously, Robert does not have a disability when it comes to art. His beautiful teapot and teacup are just magnificent. He has exhibited with us twice in our competitions, and I think he has taken a ribbon both times. Tammy Simons has another one on the wall, don't you, Tammy?
Yeah, it's the buffalo festival.
Tell us about the buffalo. It says Indian Tea Time?
Yes.
Why the title?
Why? Because it had to have a tea in it.
Oh. Silly name. Okay. And Ralph Lamaster is the last artist here on the wall. Ralph lives in California, so he's not here this time, but he will be here in July because he's Artist of the Month for July. This is his tea time. Obviously, it's a tropical tea time, and he's a terrific painter. We're so glad to have him as a member. Now, I'm going to bring Dan up, and Dan is going to be the one who announces our winners and the money attached with it. Why don't we start at the honorable mentions first?
Okay.
They have their ribbons, but if you would please stand up so everybody can get an applause.
From that one up,
and then we'll
go off.
Then you'll flip the page over.
Yeah, read slower. All right. Well, first of all, I want to say thanks for letting us come and for the opportunity to sponsor this event tonight. We sponsored one last summer, July, and we've just had a wonderful time. So when Linda came around a few months ago, we jumped at the opportunity to sponsor another one of these. It's just great. And I want to note too that Sabine Reed is here. She also works at the bank, and she's a member of the Art Association. Sabine is just a wonderful woman, and I'm so glad she works at the bank, and she's here. And I wanted to know her too. There's more than one of us here. So. But again, just appreciate the opportunity. It's always just so great to be over here. Appreciate it. Yes.
Let me tell you, when I went over to ask Dan if it was okay if they took tea time as a theme, and I said, what's tea time for you? And he said, tellers. Didn't skip a beat.
That's the first thing that popped in the head, I guess. Tellers and, money, tellers. So, with that, we'll go ahead and start naming the honorable mentions. And it looks like there's six honorable mentions. The first one is Red Canyon Trail, number 9, by artist Sandra Anderson. The next honorable mention is Tea Time, number 29, by artist Robert Cooper. The next honorable mention is Double T Ranch, number 17, by artist Jan Hansen. Can I meet Jan? Go ahead and stand up, Jan. The next honorable mention is Grandma's Hat Fatigue, number 21, Carol Peterson. Okay, the fifth honorable mention is Tammy's Tea Time, number 18, by Tammy Nielsen Simons. And I know Tammy, so there we go. Congratulations. And then the last honorable mention is Standing Tall Absence, by number 15, artist Cherie Vincent. All right, now we're talking some money here. So the white ribbon for $20, third place. The Desert is a Sacred Place by artist Judith Hedden. The red ribbon, second place, and
It's $30.
Okay.
Ralph isn't here.
Okay. The red ribbon second place for $30 is Tranquility, which is number 3 by artist Ralph Lamaster.
When we sent the email to Ralph saying that he had won a prize, Ralph very generously donated it back to Virgin Valley Artists Association.
All right, Ralph. He's everyone's favorite tonight. Okay, so our $50 blue ribbon first place is Tea Time for Two, number 27, by Geraldine Zarati. Okay, and the best of show goes to a Mr. and Mrs. Tea Breakfast, number 7, by artist Susan Holliday. Yes, so we have two more, and I think these are surprise ones, right?
Yes, they are.
We have two more surprise ones, all right. The People's Choice Award, drum roll please, goes for Time for Tea, number 12, by Janice Cochi. That's the last one is the sponsor's choice award. That's our choice. We had, I think, five or six people. Sabina, come on up here. You're part of the sponsor. We had, I think we had about six people from the bank come over and look at the paintings throughout the month, and it was almost unanimous. I mean, it was crazy how almost unanimous it was. Everyone really liked this one painting. And the one painting is Time for Tea, number 20, by artist Sally Sinclair. So, but I don't think Sally for it, unfortunately. Well, thanks again, everyone. What a great evening and beautiful art.